Hey everyone, today we're diving into something that sounds healthy, but can sneakily damage your liver if you're not careful. Some fruits may trigger or worsen fatty liver disease, but which ones and why? Stick around to the very end, because I'll also share some surprisingly good fruit choices that can actually help protect your liver. Now I'm going to break down the worst fruit types that can damage your liver. Welcome back to Diabetes Smarts, where we decode diabetes science into simple, life-saving tips. Now, you may have already heard that fruit is nature's candy. So many delicious and unique types of fruit are found all over the globe, and they are packed with vitamins, fiber, and disease-fighting, liver-protecting antioxidants. But did you know that not all fruit is the same for your body? Especially if you are over 50 and managing diabetes, prediabetes, or non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So, you need to know the four fundamental fruit offenders. First, I think we need to discuss high fructose fruits. Let's talk about fructose. It's a natural sugar found in pretty much all fruits. It's also in honey and even some vegetables. But here's the catch. Glucose gets used for energy by your entire body, and especially your muscles and your brain. But fructose is metabolized almost entirely by your liver. Instead of this form of sugar being subjected to glycolysis, or the main metabolic pathway that converts sugar into usable energy, fructose rapidly enters separate pathways that promote fat synthesis, or the metabolic pathway that converts sugar into stored fat. Basically, too much fructose equals too much liver fat. To make matters worse, fructose does not stimulate insulin or hunger hormones like leptin, and it won't fill you up, so eating fructose can easily lead to overconsuming calories and potentially add to your liver fat accumulation. That leads to oxidative stress, raised triglycerides and cholesterol levels, along with increases to your insulin resistance, inflammation, and your risk of developing non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So, here are the sweetest bombs that drop in the highest amounts of fructose per bite. Apples. They sound healthy, right? Well, they are, and their skins contain the blood sugar balancing fiber, pectin. But apples have more fructose than glucose, sometimes by a 2-to-1 ratio. And with an average 5.9 grams of fructose per 100 gram serving of apple, this fruit is one of the most fructose-filled common fruits on the planet. Here's another major fructose offender, pears. Pear skins, like apple skins, are high in fiber, potentially supplying nearly 20% of your daily fiber needs in one medium-sized pear. But like apples, it's the same old sugar story. Lots of fructose. And in fact, more fructose than an apple. With over 6 grams of fructose per 100 gram serving, pears are one of the highest fructose fruits available. Also, be wary of mangoes. This tropical treat has been called the king of fruits, as mangoes are not only uniquely delicious, they are cultivated in over 100 countries and have been classified as a superfood by nutrition experts for their wealth of disease-fighting micronutrients. But their anti-inflammatory properties can be negated if you overconsume mangoes. With a huge helping of sugar, an average 45 grams per mango, and approximately 4.7 grams of fructose per 100 gram serving, this is another high fructose fruit that will get rapidly converted to liver fat. Plus, watch out before you accidentally overeat cherries. They are very delicious and loaded with some impressive micronutrients, including antioxidant anthocyanins, which fight diabetes-linked oxidative stress and inflammation. But cherries also contain over 4.5 grams of fructose per serving. That gives them a moderate fructose to glucose ratio. However, these little bursts of natural sweetness are shockingly easy to overeat. And there's another tiny fruit bursting with flavor and beneficial antioxidants that is extremely easy to overeat. I think there's a good chance you may be overdoing your intake of grapes. For many families, it's natural to keep a consistent supply of grapes in the fridge. They're certainly a better snack option than most processed sweet treats, and grapes are a great place to get glucose-balancing, anti-inflammatory antioxidants like resveratrol, quercetin, catechins, and anthocyanins. Now, though their nutritional profile would have you believe they are relatively low in sugar, eating a cup of grapes could add up to about 25 grams of total sugar consumed in a very quick amount of time. And while grapes are slightly less loaded with fructose than the other fruits we've just mentioned, they still carry a 1-to-1 glucose to fructose ratio, meaning they carry basically the same amount of fructose as glucose. So if you often mindlessly eat handfuls of grapes, that can potentially spike your blood sugar and increase your risk of NAFLD. Quick reminder, stay with us to the end of this video to see the fruits that actively improve liver health. Okay, next I want to talk about plain old high sugar fruits. There are some types of fresh fruit that are relatively low in fructose, but still very high in total sugar content. So over-consuming these fruits can easily lead to spikes in your glucose and damage to your liver. Watch your intake of bananas. Though they give you more glucose and sucrose than fructose, one medium-sized banana could still throw about 5 grams of fructose at your liver. But the real problem here is their total sugar amount, 12 to 14 grams per banana. And more ripe bananas have concentrated amounts of starch and sugar, making it a high glycemic index food. One of the sweeter fruits is, of course, pineapple. I love pineapple, and you probably do as well. And you can count on it to give you a huge range of anti-inflammatory antioxidants. But a major reason it tastes so deliciously refreshing is that it is one of the most high-sugar, high-glycemic fruits in the world. Studies prove that high-glycemic foods like pineapple can increase lipogenesis, or the body's process of converting your excess carbohydrates and proteins into stored fat. And it gives you a lot of carbs. Eating a cup of pineapple could bring your body the equivalent of 3 to 5 teaspoons of sugar. That's about 50% of your daily recommended sugar intake right there. Plus, while most of its sugar is in the form of sucrose, and it does have a more respectable glucose to fructose ratio than some other fruits, that doesn't let it off the hook. Pineapple still gives you 2 to 3 grams of fructose per serving. So eating it too much or too often will load you up on a whole lot of sugar and a sizable amount of liver-damaging fructose. Also, when it comes to sugary fruits, you need to know the truth about melons. In the summer, it can be easy to overindulge in cantaloupes, honeydew, and watermelon. But these refreshing classics come with a twist. They sound like they are full of hydration and nutrients, which they are, but they are critically lacking in fiber content. On top of that, they are shockingly high in sugar content. And while a fruit like watermelon is over 90% water, it is still at the top end of fruits on the glycemic index scale. Servings of melons can often give you 12 to 14 grams of carbohydrates, and most of that is in the form of sugar. In fact, a 100-gram serving of cantaloupe has been reported to contain 14.4 grams of total carbohydrates. So how much of that do you think is sugar? Try 14 grams. Yeah, pretty much all of the carb content of many melons is pure, simple sugar. Honeydew can also give you over 15 grams of carbohydrates per cup, with nearly all of it in the form of sugar and barely any fiber. In fact, most all melons are notoriously lacking in fiber content. So while melons are delicious and nutritious, you have to be careful not to overindulge in these sweet summertime treats. They can easily lead to blood sugar spikes and increased liver fat. Now, when it comes to eating high fructose and high carb fresh fruits, here's a pro tip. The danger is in the quantity. Eating one serving of these fruits can raise your blood sugar, but shouldn't lead to a serious glucose spike, especially if you pair it with a certain type of food. Stay tuned to learn more about that. But just know that habitually over-snacking on these fruits can raise your risk of diabetes and fatty liver disease. Okay, so I've just covered the two major types of fresh fruit that are most dangerous for your liver, but what are the other two fruit offenders? Studies show that a major culprit in the global rise of diabetes and a huge contributor to fatty liver disease comes from drinking your fruit. So be extremely mindful not to overconsume fruit juices. Don't be fooled. Even 100% fruit juices with no added sugars are still full of sugar, with basically zero fiber content. But here's the thing about liquid sugar from your favorite fruits. Juiced fruits have extremely high levels of total sugar and fructose, because fruit juice is essentially a concentrated liquid extract. The juicing process and the removal of fiber also concentrates the fruit's glucose to fructose ratio. In fact, a cup of apple juice can contain 28 grams of total carbohydrates, with 24 of those grams in the form of sugar, and over half of that is pure fructose. So fruit juice floods your system with quick sugar, and a significant portion of that sugar will go directly to your liver, where it gets converted into triglycerides and fat. The last type of fruit that can be especially problematic suffers from the same issues as fruit juice. I'm talking about concentration, so you should be wary of dried fruits. This style of fruit can be quite insidious. Packaged dried fruit products are often marketed as healthy and natural snacks, but just like fruit juice, they have extremely concentrated amounts of total sugar and fructose. This also means that dried fruits give you concentrated amounts of beneficial antioxidants, but that can end up being a perception problem, because many people report accidentally overeating dried fruits, believing they are purely good for you. Drying a fruit also removes all of its water content, which increases its glycemic index and allows its sugar to become absorbed into your bloodstream more rapidly. So watch out before you scarf down a huge helping of dates, figs, raisins, dried apricots, and other dried fruit products. They are all ridiculously high in total sugar and fructose content. In fact, according to the USDA, 100 grams of raisins can give you a staggering 300 calories, with nearly 80 grams of total carbohydrates. And basically, 60 out of those 80 grams are pure sugar. And raisin fructose can account for a whopping 30 to 35 grams per 100-gram serving. And now you know the four major fruit offenders when it comes to liver damage. But as promised, here's another pro tip. Pair your fruits, and especially any of these four types of fruits, with quality sources of protein. This macronutrient helps to slow your digestion and your body's absorption of sugar. So, eat your favorite fruits with a small portion of unsweetened Greek yogurt, mozzarella cheese, almonds, cashews, or walnuts. Now, I also promised you some good news. There are several types of fresh fruit that are significantly better for your liver and can actually bring you big liver-protecting benefits. So, in moderation, don't be afraid to enjoy strawberries, blueberries, and blackberries, lemons and limes, grapefruit, kiwi fruit, and even avocado. Yep, avocado is actually a berry. Make sure to stay tuned to our channel. I'll show you exactly why these fruits are good for your liver in an upcoming video. So when it comes to fruit, the data is clear. Most every piece of fresh fruit will give you specific micronutrients that fight the effects of diabetes, but it will also contain large helpings of sugar. So, overeating most any type of fruit can easily spike your glucose levels, heighten your insulin resistance, and contribute to weight gain. And some fruits are especially problematic for your liver. So remember, do eat all your favorite fruits, but in moderation. And if you are worried about fatty liver disease, it is best to scale way back on your apples, bananas, mangoes, grapes, watermelons, fruit juices, dried fruits, and other high fructose, sugar-loaded fruits. Thanks for watching. What did you think about this topic? And what other topics would you like us to cover? Let us know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and check out the Diabetes Smarts video collection to gain more vital knowledge about your liver, your blood sugar, and your overall health. Until next time, stay smart, stay healthy, and take care of that liver.